Calls for Virginia's Governor Ralph Northam to resign have grown in recent days amid furor over a racist photograph that appeared on Northam's medical school yearbook page, showing one person in blackface and another dressed in a Ku Klux Klan uniform. The photo is raising concerns about the culture at Northam's medical school and has reopened the long history of bigotry and racism in American medicine, especially for African Americans who were already distrustful of doctors. A 2016 study by the University of Virginia found that a significant number of white medical students and residents believe that black people are less sensitive to pain. Sylvia Perry, a researcher and assistant professor at Northwestern University, said that's not the only hurdle black patients are up against.
Indeed, the stereotypes that physicians can hold about black individuals, about their ability to get better, about their willingness to adhere to treatment and to come back, can shape the decisions that they make when they're making a judgment about whether a patient should receive certain medication and certain treatments.
It does have an effect on your level of trust.
Keith Brown organizes health fairs to encourage other black men to take care of themselves, but he's had his own reasons to be skeptical of receiving treatment. After going to the ER for chest pain in 2017, a doctor performed a heart cath through his wrist, damaging a nerve in the process. He still has no feeling in his right hand. Brown said experiences like his and seeing images of blackface in a medical school yearbook only sow distrust among black Americans.
It raises red flags. It makes you very curious as to, you know, the doctors that you are seeing, you know, how do they feel about you just because of the color of your skin?
That skepticism has historical precedent. For decades, starting in 1932, hundreds of unsuspecting black men with syphilis were left untreated in Alabama so government researchers could track the disease's progress. That infamous experiment is now commonly known as the Tuskegee Syphilis Study.
For the sake of science, they sacrificed some human beings. And it raised the question, did they really believe these men were human beings? And so we really wonder about their intention as well as their behavior.
For many patients today, the fear of medical mistreatment persists.
Is this person being cold to me because they had a bad day? Or are they showing coldness toward me because they actually don't like me because of my race? And so I think a lot of that ambiguity is really difficult for black patients, especially given the history.
Perry said the photo in Northam's yearbook erases some of that ambiguity.
It's like they can finally put a name to a face, literally, and say, you know, this is an example. Like, this is exactly what I'm talking about.
Big deep breaths in and out through your mouth.
Nori Nasser, The Associated Press.